Hey people, today we'll be looking at some analytics done on 752 popular songs in order to analyze which chords, combination of chords, and chord progressions tend to appear more. Hopefully, these insights will be useful to you in improving your knowledge on chords, as well as your ability to correctly guess and recognize these chords just by listening. For some background, I scraped over 1,000 of the most popular songs and their chords from ultimateguitar.com using some Python, and stored the collected data somewhere on my computer. As many songs were in different keys, I transposed all of them to C major so that we can compare them fairly. Of course, there are quite a few problematic ones where chords were written in weird formats and so on, so we omitted those and were left with 752 songs and their chords in C major. Enough with the background talk, let's dive into what we managed to find out from analyzing this data. First off, here's a graph showing which chords appeared most frequently. As we can see, unsurprisingly, the top 6 chords that appear the most in the songs are the 6 chords made from the notes in the C major scale: C major, G major, F major, A minor, D minor, and E minor. Out of these 6 chords, C major, G major, F major, and A minor appear the most. These 4 chords are truly the most common chords that many songs use, so if you're trying to figure out some chords for a song, there's a high chance that it might be a combination of these 4 chords. Here's the same graph showing which chords appeared most frequently, but extended to include the top 12 most frequently used chords. Notice that the next 6 most frequently used chords are used much less than the top 4 chords. These 6 chords are also known as chromatic chords, which simply refers to any chord that contains at least one note that is not in the home key, which is C major in this case. The first 6 chords, where all notes inside are from the home key, are in turn called diatonic chords. In a nutshell, a majority of chords used are diatonic chords, while chromatic chords are sometimes added in to add some color and spice to the song. I'll cover more about diatonic and chromatic chords in a future video, but let's move on for now. Next, this graph shows the top 10 2 chord sequences that appear the most frequently in all the songs. Unsurprisingly, the top 2 chord sequences are made up from the top 4 most used chords. Despite this, the graph gives us some idea of which chords tend to lead to which other chords. Here are the top 6 chords that tend to come after the C major chord, sorted from the most frequent to the least frequent. One interesting pattern we can see is that the C major chord tends to lead to the G major chord, much more so than any other chord. The next graph shows the top chords that come after D minor. Here we can see that again, the G major chord wins here, but not by such a large proportion as compared to C major's case. Next, we have E minor, our least common chord out of the 6 diatonic chords. We can clearly see that the E minor chord likes to lead into either the A minor or the F major chord, and the others much less. Here we have the top 6 chords that come after the F major chord. The C major chord is clearly the winner here by a pretty large margin, followed by the G major chord. Next, we have the most frequent chords that come after the G major chord. Here, the C major chord wins, followed closely by the A minor chord, and then the F major chord, which is not too far off. Lastly, for the A minor chord, the F major chord wins by a large margin, followed by the G major chord, then the C major chord. For each of the chords from C major to A minor, the top 3 chords that tend to follow them are shown. Do take note of which chords tend to lead to which chord, as this can be useful when you're trying to figure out chords by ear. Finally, here are the top 10 most common chord progressions found in all 752 songs. One interesting pattern is that every single one of these 6 progressions contain only the 4 most used chords: C major, A minor, G major, and F major, in one permutation or another. This actually applies to many pop songs out there. So many songs contain just these 4 chords played in the same permutation throughout the entire song. For those who are just starting out on their ear training journey, one tip to speed up their learning curve would be to familiarize yourself with these 4 most common chords first. Even if you can only identify these 4 chords by ear for now, you can already play thousands and thousands of songs by ear with just these 4 chords. That being said, these insights were generated on a rather small dataset of only 752 pop songs and are not meant to be representative of all the songs in the world. Nevertheless, do continue to be consistent in practicing how to play by ear, and I hope that these insights were at least somewhat useful for you. Thank you for watching, and do consider giving this video a like if you feel that I'm giving you value, and do subscribe if you haven't already and don't wish to miss more of these videos. I'll see you in the next one.